Hello friends, welcome to another video. This is a non-fabric video. In last few weeks since fabric has been launched, I'm doing a lot more videos on fabric, but this is a Power BI visualization video. Basically, in this video we are going to look into what are the different methods we can use to compare value of two different categories. Why should we using one method over another? We will explore all the functionalities in this video. Let's get to Power BI and take a look at the requirement and the solution. Here in Power BI, I have a simple data table where we have location, item, fiscal year, value, and sheet. The ask here is, we want to compare data from one sheet with the another sheet. So basically, user will select a sheet value in a slicer, and then user will also select another sheet value in a second slicer, and then we will compare the value of those two selection and visualize the data. In the past, there are many videos done on this particular topic, how to compare categories with disconnected tables and all that stuff. We will be using a similar approach, but we will be looking at the two different methods and the importance of those methods. So what I've done so far in this one is, this is a simple data, and then I created two tables which are just the unique value of sheet column. The reason why we need that, because that's what we're going to use in the slicer. So I have a sheet slicer one, I called it, and these are the unique values. And also I created another one, sheet slicer two, because we need two different tables, because that's how we want to use it in the in our slicer. And here, if you look at that, what I did is a slicer one, which is coming sheet, and it's coming from slicer one, sheet slicer one table, and the second slicer is coming from sheet slicer two table. And a single select so that we can compare value with the based on the selection. And I just created a graph here, a visual a bar chart, where we have a location on x-axis and the sheet on the legend. Now again, the sheet on the legend for this visual, I have taken it from the my data table, not from the sheet slicer one and slicer two. So to write the measure, there are two, again, this is the method one, which I'm gonna talk about. And let's add a measure here. What the measure is gonna do is gonna look into what items has been selected in the slicer and get the value of those selected slicer values. So let's call it sum legend. I will tell you why I'm giving the name legend here. So what we need to do is calculate sum. Again, sum, I have a base measure, which is just a sum of value. That is this particular measure I have done in that. Now, what we need is we need what is selected here in these two slices. So the easiest way we can do is we can use PeryTUS. And again, I have done many videos on PeryTUS. Do check out those videos. So we're going to treat as and make a table of these two selected value, and then use that as a relationship or filter our data table. So how we can do that? So if we use the curly bracket, what we're going to do is values from sheet slicer one, and then values from sheet slicer two. So what does this means is, now this becomes a table with two rows, one value selected from this slicer, slicer one, and the value selected from slicer two. So that's when we have that, and now we can filter our data table. And hang on a second, I have to finish. So data table, and then we want to filter our sheet column in our data table. So finish this. And now basically again, what we have here is in PeryTUS, we are combining the data from both the selected and created a table. And then we're using that table to filter our data table or the column sheet in that table. So if I use this measure now in my bar chart here, so what you will see is the value is getting repeated for all the locations which we have on the x-axis. And the reason why it is happening, and it's showing us all the sheets. If you look at the legend, we are seeing all the sheets, but we want only the one which we selected. And again, it is happening because what we need to do is we need to pass the row filter context to the filter context, so to filter our PeryTUS table. So what we're going to do is keep filters. Do check out videos on the keep filters, which has more details. I'm not going to explain the whole thing in here. So we're going to keep filters and wrap our PeryTUS in that. And let's see the end result. Here you go. So what we have here is now we have project 310 and project app. That's what has been selected, and showing it by location. So that's what the comparison is. If I pick another here, project revised, and then whole thing is changed. And if I pick same project from both the slices, and we will get a single value because there's nothing to compare. So this is working as expected. Now the question comes is this the only way, or what is another way to do that? The another way we can think of doing it, create a separate measure for each slicer selection and use that in the visualization. Let's try to do that. We're gonna add another measure here. Let's call it sum slicer one. This is pretty straightforward. We'll calculate sum. First keep filters again, because we want that. And treat as. Now in this case, we don't need to do the curly brackets because the values will return a table. So that will be sheet slicer sheet one. And then we are filtering our data table, column sheet, sorry. Okay, so that is of sum slicer one. So that's the first measure, and then we will create another one, sum slicer two. Okay, in this case, we will take the values from our sheet slicer two, and the rest will remain the same. Okay, so now we have two separate measures, one based on the selection here, and we will use those measures in our visual here. So well, let's go to add those measures. So if I go sum slicer one here, now here is a problem, because if I have a sheet on the legend from my data table, I cannot use the multiple measures. That's how these visuals work. So to use multiple measures, I need to remove a sheet column from my legend. So I'm going to remove that. And I'm also going to remove my existing measure, which is sum legend. And I'm going to add sum slicer one on my y-axis and sum slicer two on my second measure on the visual. And now if I pick a different value from my slicer one, so I can see the comparison. So it got the same result as what we have with the one visual. But here the issue is with the presentation here, because on the legend, what it will show you sum slicer one and sum slicer two, not like when we used legend and a single measure, which we created previously, we were able to see the selected value on our visual here. But with the two separate measures, unfortunately, it will always show you sum slicer one and or whatever the name of the measure is. We cannot dynamically show the values of the selected values of selected sheet in our legend. So that's the challenge. So it's again, it's your choice. Do you want to create one single measure and use that in the video and show actual selected values on the legend? Of course, the obvious choice will be using one single measure and showing it the values on the selected value in the slicer. But I have another use case here where using two separate measures are make more sense. Again, this is all depends on how you want to visualize the data. Let's assume that we are making this as an matrix visual instead of a bar chart. So I'm going to switch this to a matrix visual. So this works perfectly fine here. And now let's say the ask here is that we also want to show the variance in the total here, slicer value 2 minus selected slicer value, deduct the difference between these two, right? Slicer 2 value minus slicer 1 value, and whatever the variance is, we want to show that. And so first of all, on this one, in the matrix visual, if I use the sheet on my, because now in matrix visual, because the bar chart does not allow us to use any column on the legend if we have two different measures. But in this particular case, in matrix visual, we have the option to use the sheet on our columns. We can use two measures and we can also use the sheet. So on our columns. So now this makes more sense. So what we have is we have a project 310 project app and the sum slicer one here. And now sum slicer two will be blank because we have a keep filters. So this one is showing us the, a blank value here. And when we are in the project app, which is the second selection, the sum slicer one is showing blank because that is, we have the keep filters applied on this. So what in this particular case we're saying is just give us the value of project app, which is in sum slicer two and not on sum slicer one. So this doesn't look correct in this case. But let's say if we are using, instead of this one, we wanted to use our original measure, which is sum legend. And we know that will work because that work in the, that worked in our bar chart as well. So now the question is, I want to show instead of total, I wanted to show the variance between these two values. So project app minus project 310, that's what I wanted to show. So what we can do here is we can add another measure and try to add another measure and see if that solves. So let's see how we will do that. So let's add another measure here. I'm gonna call it sum matrix, just for the sake of showing the example. So let's call it sum matrix. So what we're gonna do is, if we have a column, if we have a sheet value, then we will show whatever the value is in the measure. And if we are at the total, we will show second value minus the first value. Now, the challenge here is, let's first try to do this. So let's go, if is blank, or actually we can do if selected value data table sheet is blank, it means we are at the total at that point, because selected value in this particular column here, it will return the value project 310. In this particular column, it will return the value project app. And in this particular case, it will return blank. So we'll be saying, okay, if it is blank, then let's say return value 0, otherwise just sum legend. So now let's use this measure on the visual here. Okay, so this is working in a way that we still have a project 310 value, we have a project app value, and the total, because we said, okay, this is, if we don't have any sheet value, which is project 310 project app, then show zero. Like if I make it -1, the total will be -1. So this is working, should work fine here. It will show -1. Yeah, here you go. So this is working. So what we need in this particular case is, because we want the slicer 2 selected value minus slicer 1 selected value, so it means we wanted whatever this 164 million and minus 663. Let's make it a decimal value to 0, because there's so many after decimal value. Okay, here you go. So we want value, second value to be, and subtract the first value to find out the variance. So to do so, instead of -1 here, what we need is, we need to find out what the project app value is and what the project 310 value is. With a single measure, unfortunately, we cannot do that because it's only single one single measure. We cannot deduct and use that to find the variance. So to achieve this, we still need to go back to the two separate measures which we have created previously. So what we need to do here is, we have to do that sum slicer 2, because we know the sum slicer 2 is based on the values selected on the slicer 2, minus sum slicer 1. Here you go. So to achieve this, basically, depending on the visualization and what you're trying to achieve, what we need is, we probably need to make the combination of a single measure and maybe also the combination of two different measures to make this work. If the requirement was just to show the data in the bar chart with the legend, then the single measure would have worked perfectly fine. But as the requirement changed, what we need to do here is, we need a single measure of to show the legend, and also we need to show the variance. We need those two separate measure based on the each selection. I hope you found this a visual and small a use case of how you can compare categories using two separate measures and also using a single measure. But again, it all goes down to how you really want to visualize your data, and then based on that you will make the selection that, do you really need a single measure, or you need a separate measure based on the each selection. Let me know what you guys think about this video. I hope you learned something out of this video. I know this comparing the categories and has done many times, but in this particular case, I just want to show you guys two different methods and which one to use and why, how you should be approaching this. Let me know what you guys think. Do subscribe my channel. Until next video, have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Thank you.